Hey, what's up? We are Zebra and Giraffe.
Hi, my name is Emmanuel Cassis, and we're here at the Hard Rock Cafe for Zebra and Giraffe's album launch, Knuckles. And it was fantastic. What a good evening.
It's the first time we heard the songs live, and they sound as good as the album, so we can't complain. It's been a cool evening. A whole bunch of guys, a lot of industry guys here as well, and a lot of media and stuff, so we all had a good time.
And it was very enjoyable.
Very. I did snaps and everything. It was awesome.
I was in an interesting headspace when I wrote Knuckles. It was a little bit different to the Wisest Ones. The Wisest Ones, if you listen to the album, you can tell I was in a pretty dark space, and that's reflected on most of the lyrics on the album. Knuckles was a new space for me because I was a lot more positive and happy and just in generally in life, and I just moved to Cape Town, so it was nice to write in somewhere new. I'd never written in a new place. I'd always written in Joburg. So to write in a new place like that, and just, I suppose, being happy changes things, and a few of the songs on the album reflect that kind of headspace.
Greg's been living in Cape Town for about a year now, so it didn't really change much in terms of the process. It didn't affect the process, because what generally happens is Greg will write some sort of idea, or sometimes, you know, come to us with a fully produced song from his end, and then we take it as a band, and we normally, Michael, record drums on top of it, and we'll start to figure out what we want to do in the song. So the logistics never had an impact on the process, really.
We worked with a lady called Shy, and she her main job, I suppose, was me. She had to help me with the vocal production and just delivering the vocals. And it's something that I always feared going to studio before. It's always something that gets left to the last minute. So we'll record drums, we'll record bass, guitars, keyboards, and then right at the end you usually do the vocals. And what inevitably happens is you're left with a very little bit of time. That always puts a lot of pressure on singers, and I was under huge amounts of pressure, especially on the inside. The Wisest Ones I ended up doing by myself, which has its pros and its cons as well, but I think when you do stuff yourself, especially vocals, you tend to over-criticize yourself and try and make it perfect instead of giving it a feeling and connecting with the song. We worked for almost a year just on basic vocal stuff, not even singing lessons per se, but how to deliver a vocal, how to get in touch with the lyrics and sing the lyrics and not focus on what it sounds like. So it was a huge thing for me, and going to studio this time was amazing. I enjoyed it. There was no pressure, it was fun. She stepped me through the process like a vocal producer is supposed to do, and I've never done that before. So it was fun, and I'm excited to record vocals again.
The reason we went with an EP as opposed to a full-length album is mainly because nobody really buys full albums these days anymore. With iTunes instant gratification, you can either download one song, or you can download two songs, or just, you know, whatever. So EP just makes more sense as just making the best tracks that we can do, as opposed to just making filler tracks on an album.
Doing an album every 2 years, you know, it's a long period of time to like do an album, tour, write a new one, and I think people want content quickly, and they kind of, I think there's not as much investment in content these days. So before, when you would go and buy a book or a CD or a vinyl, you'd have to get out to your house, go to the store, look through all the CDs, pick out one, go home, put it in the CD player and play it, and there was an investment in that. Like you were investing in that piece of, you know, it was physical, but you were going out and doing something. Now it's so easy to just download it. And what happens with that is I think it's the music becomes a little bit more disposable. So you tend to like, I mean, I still like my favorite bands. I still buy the new Nine Inch Nails, but you listen to it a lot quicker, and it's so easily accessible that it just changes your relationship to music. And I think with that in mind, we need to create more content. So we need to create more videos, photos. We're constantly creating more content, and I think that's what people want these days.
Coming up with an idea for a sound or you know, themes for this album, I suppose normally you try and keep everything in sort of one genre, so to speak, or a certain, you know, a certain style of influence, maybe one of our two of our influences. With the new album, we kind of threw that to the side, and just instead of trying to make a rock album, we just tried to make the best album that we possibly could. We ended up with these six songs, six great songs. In terms of style, you know, stylistically, they're all quite different, which was really fun for us, which was really great experimenting in studio.
We chose the word knuckles because it was a cool word, I think. Yeah. Like, it sounded, it was like, we liked the sound of it, but if you actually look at it, the mental fight that's talked about in knuckles, it kind of reflects what we went through recording this album. It was tough. And what we've been through as a band, Steph joined us at a really interesting time. It was, we weren't really sure where we were going a couple of years ago, and that's when we met Shai, and she kind of turned things around with us. And her and Daryl have been working with us for the last, I think it's about 2 years now. Just, you know, sometimes you have to break things down and build them up again, and that's what we needed to do. And it was a hard process. And that's, I think, that the knuckles represents that. The word knuckles and what it means to us and what the song means represents the last 2 years to us. Now, in December this year, we're doing a tour down the coast. The dates aren't finalized yet. We are playing at St. Francis the Ruins for New Year's, so you can catch us there. And before that, we'll be coming down the coast. So check out our website or Facebook, and we'll announce the dates probably in the next month or so.
Hey, this is Mike from Zeb & Giraffe. We just got off stage here at the Hard Rock Cafe in Joburg. It was an awesome show. Super rad playing to all our fans, seeing some friendly faces in the crowd. I had a rocker. See you next time.